headaches and five for my lonely and six for my
all right we are back here at Song of the Day, coming to you from the Rock Cave. I'm your host Mark Pierce. It's Tuesday, Tasty Tunage Tuesday. Another day here in the cave. We were off yesterday. I was trying to pull that together, just couldn't manage it due to the late night on Sunday and then quick turnaround in the morning. As I mentioned, we were heading out. My wife and I, we saw a concert on Sunday night. Had a super good time. This band here, the Violent Femmes, and that's what we're talking about today. For those of you who are fans, we had a great time at this show. They are doing the 40th anniversary tour of their debut self-titled record, released in April of 1983, 40 years ago. That's crazy. Anyway, for those of you who don't know Violent Femmes, formed in Milwaukee, 1981, 18-year-old Gordon Gano and Brian Ritchie on bass. Gordon wrote the majority of these songs when he was 18-year-old high school student. Pretty amazing. And that record came down. Basically, if you heard this, if you listened to college radio or you had a friend that was in college, like had an older brother or sister in college, and then you went off to college in the 80s, and it was a staple in the dorms to be playing this record. It's even referred to as an enduring classic. The CD came out in 1987. They added a couple extra songs on there, but boy, growing up with this record, you know, they called it folk punk is what they've called it, this band. And I'm just like, all right, so click on it and you say, what's folk punk? And it's basically the Pogues and Violent Femmes. That's it. But the opener did do a song from the Pogues. So there you go. That brought it back around. When you listen to this when you were a kid, because of the lyrics and because of this, the irreverent style to it, yes, it was kind of folky, but it never occurred to me. But because of the lyrics and what they were saying and his voice, it felt like you were listening to, you know, definitely something, you were on to some kind of punk band that, like, underground, that nobody was listening to, that was not like mainstream. You weren't going to hear this on the radio because of some of the swearing and some of the topics, and I don't know, it just made you feel extra cool when you were listening to this record. Again, these songs, all this whole album, you can listen to it front to back, and as we all did, and we just know all the words to all these songs, and so much fun. Again, they put out 10 albums. They had 19 singles. But this is the one that they that really is the one that put them on the map, that sticks and holds true to this day. The crowd would be what you would expect. They all look like 50, 60 years old and trying to get your... I did see someone with a Bad Brains t-shirt on and some original Violent Femmes shirts. But this show was sold out. At College Street Music Hall in New Haven, there was standing, it was a general admission on the floor. We were in the seats on the balcony, perfect seats. Those days are gone for me to be standing for that long. We're just old. They did the whole albums right off the bat from beginning to end, and they sounded awesome. The vocalist sounded great, Gordon's sounded awesome, that guitar work was amazing. They had a giant, I don't know what, there's a picture in here somewhere. I mean, it looks like a giant saxophone, but it looks like 6.5 feet tall. It's massive. Never seen any instrument like that. And the drummer had a Weber grill there that he would tap on every once in a while, which was pretty funny. But they did all those songs, and the crowd was super, super happy, singing along the whole time. Pretty amazing. And if you don't know this record, you should be checking it out. But, of course, Blister in the Sun, Kiss Off, Please Don't Go, Add It Up, Confessions, that's Side A, Prove My Love, Promise, To the Kill, Gone Daddy Gone, and Good Feeling. How do you even pick a favorite there? Pretty awesome. When they re-released the CD, when they put the CD out originally in 87, they added some extra tracks, including Give Me the Car, which I don't know why that one didn't make it on the record. That's a great song. And then when they re-released it later with some B-sides, these B-sides are really good. Two of them in particular that I listen to all the time are Girl Trouble and Waiting for the Bus. Two amazing tracks that we'll post as well below. Those will be your deep cuts almost a Wanderlust Wednesday on Tuesday for you here from Violent Femmes. But so good and so much fun, and the crowd just had a great time. And boy, if you can see this tour and if you were a fan of this music when you were in college or high school, then you should go check it out. I can't pick a song. It's hard to pick a song of the day from all of these because I love Prove My Love. And I love Kiss Off and Blister of the Sun and Please Don't Go and Add It Up and all that stuff. So we'll just post a bunch of them below so you can click on them and you can revisit them. It's amazing how you know the words to songs even if you haven't listened to them in a long time. So much fun. I can't say it enough. Violent Femmes, great time. Awesome. Another concert in the books. All right, people, whatever you're doing today, I hope it involves music. And today you're listening to Violent Femmes, the beginning to end, and check out those deep cuts. And as usual, I'll catch you on the flip side.